mentioned, my name's Briar. We are definitely a new group. We've formed just last year out of a community conversation around wanting to control the wasps in our area. So we just started those conversations. We'd had a few chats around doing some plant control, some pest control locally as well, but it was the wasps that really got us all actually starting those conversations to really pull us together. And what followed ended up going from just wanting to put a bit of Vespex on a few properties to realizing the scale that we actually needed to perform that at to actually make some sort of meaningful difference. If I share my screen, let's see if I can do this one. Has that come up for everybody? Is that, I can't actually hear anyone.
Yes.
Okay, fantastic. Has that gone to a slideshow, Pamela?
Yes.
Okay, fantastic. So this is really all I've got to show. I'm going to keep it really quick. The red line shows the area that we ended up deciding to control within. So Kitewaho Road kind of comes along and it loops around Kitewaho Reserve. Originally, we just decided to stick with our street, but we had a fantastic conversation with Peter and Juliet from Pest Free Piha quite early on in our planning stage, and they really helped us to realize kind of what they'd learned through their pilot study and where we needed to take our program to really make that difference with the Vespex. And so we sort of stretched it as far as we felt comfortable while we just found our own feet as well. So it covers an area of around 35 hectares, which listening to everyone else's chats this night makes it seem quite little, but it still felt like a rather mammoth task for us to actually achieve. And definitely, I just listening to Sue's talk, I was really hearing a lot about, even at that the landscape level, a lot of that applied to our little local level as well. A lot of our time went into that organization and just figuring out what we were doing. Approaching all the landowners and getting permission to actually access on private land. We had overwhelming response from the local community and everyone wanted us to come on their land and do bait stations. So over the 35 hectares, we ended up placing 71 bait stations with approximately a 50 meter radius around them. And that was really achievable. We had 4 Vespex users and we had fantastic support through Tracy at Council and Amy, as well as funding from the Waitakere Rangers Local Board. And it was just, overwhelming support in the way of giving us advice on what we needed to be doing. And also just from the community, we just had so many people in the community keen to help out and to get the project finished. So that's pretty much where we're at. We haven't gone much beyond that, but we're really keen to continue this and actually extend further into Scenic Drive and much further over into the reserve and the regional parkland beneath us. We needed to get permission for Kitewaho Reserve, which is in the center of our control site. And so we were actually given permission to bait in there as part of a pilot program for volunteers working in public land. And it went really, really well. So hopefully we can continue that and get access into the regional park beneath us as well. Again, listening to the words tonight and thinking about how defensible our control site is, we are sort of in a sea of regional parkland. And so we do need to think about how we can actually continue that and then thinking about what species we might want to move on to next. So that's me.
Thank you.